When storms were spotted on the radar headed for Duluth, Minnesota in October 2018, weather experts knew it would be a big one, with winds that topped 65 miles an hour and waves that sent water pummeling over the barriers that are designed to protect the shore.
Our modeling estimated that there were somewhere between 12 to 16 foot waves out there on Lake Superior.
The storm pounded the area for several hours, and when it finally settled, the shoreline was shattered.
The lake walk that Duluth is well known for was obliterated. It was pretty ugly. I think a lot of people that went there the next day were like, wow, what happened? It looks like a bomb.
I think it was the next day when I finally realized, like, oh wow, the lake walk is tore up. You know, in the months following that, and even like the next year, you heard people talking about like, oh, I thought Duluth was closed, or, you know, like the lake walk isn't available, and that's such a big staple of Duluth that I think some people, you know, said, oh, well, if that's not open, like, let's not go, let's go elsewhere.
Our residents said very loud and clearly that they didn't want this infrastructure to go away. This is a very popular recreational area, also supports a lot of local businesses and our tourism industry. And so we knew we had to do it a different way and think a little bit more about coastal resiliency.
And in order to do that, local and state officials called on FEMA, which pumped more than $9 million into the project with a hazard mitigation grant. Engineers designed a new seawall that would last longer and withstand stronger storms caused by climate change.
The toe of the slope was really carefully engineered, and the rocks were placed with a lot of thought and intention by engineering and design folks. The wall helps further protect that slope. And then we even incorporated some stormwater runoff treatment and some native plants to help with any of that wash that comes over and treat that and get it back out to the lake. So all of those things help to protect this important infrastructure for our lake walk.
And now the new lake walk is once again bustling with business, noontime bikers, and those who simply want to enjoy the beautiful view.
Well, what I saw going to this project was, like, you know, over-designed so that whatever weather storms are looking like in 20, 30, 40 years, it should be able to withstand that. And I really think of it as a legacy project. It's so nice, it's gorgeous, and it's just a huge asset to Duluth.
Knowing that we can rely on the federal government, we can lean on some of those resources to build back better following an event like this means a lot.
For us especially, to build it back better, taking a chunk out of that $15 million price tag and knowing that over half of that could come from federal dollars helped us put that stake in the ground to say we're going to build it back better. We're going to make it more resilient.
We encourage community leaders to learn more about our hazard mitigation grants to see how we can help before disaster hits. Check us out online at www.fema.gov.